But first, Australians go to the polls tomorrow, casting their votes in one of the most tightly contested federal elections in our history.
Julia Gillard is out to save Labor from becoming a one-term wonder, while Tony Abbott is looking to oust our first female Prime Minister, who's been in the top job for just a matter of weeks.
We'll speak to both of them in a few moments, but first, TEN's political editor Paul Bongiorno takes a look at the final day of campaigning.
Last time, Bennelong was the jewel in Labor's crown. This time, it's on a knife edge.
Oh, welcome.
Julia Gillard couldn't help but be encouraged by this reception. Tony Abbott was chasing the love through the night on a 36-hour vote bender. He even found time for a spot of tennis under lights.
I had to finish well.
Yes.
That's the name of the game, finishing
well. Well, you're on a winning streak now. Yeah.
He got back to his hotel in the early hours for a series of radio interviews.
It's been a long night, and it's not quite over.
At dawn, he was hardly fresh as a daisy, but news poll suggests he'll come up smelling of roses tomorrow. It's 50-50, two-party preferred. A closer look tips the result his way.
There is a real risk that Mr Abbott will be Prime Minister of Australia on Sunday.
A Galaxy poll gave the Prime Minister something to smile at. It was 52-48 her way.
I've said right throughout this election campaign I am the underdog.
In 1961, the Menzies coalition government clung to power by just one seat. On today's polls, confusing and all as they are, that's probably Labor's best case scenario. Just as plausible, Tony Abbott leads the coalition to a victory. To a mass meeting of unionists in Sydney's West, Julia Gillard returned to the winning theme of the last election, work choices, quoting a Joe Hockey answer on Never Ever.
And he says to that, no, 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 yeah, but. Well, doesn't that say it all? Doesn't that say it all?
I will absolutely guarantee that work choices in any name is dead, buried and cremated.
Tony Abbott says election campaigns are grueling, but he's risen to the challenge. Few could disagree. Julia Gillard has put in a strong finish after sustaining damaging friendly fire early. Paul Bongiorno, 10 News.
Now, both leaders are with us live tonight in Sydney. Julia Gillard's in Penrith, Tony Abbott at Observatory Hill. Firstly, we'll talk to the Prime Minister. Prime Minister, in a few sentences, why should we re-elect you tomorrow?
I'm asking Australians to endorse my positive plan for the nation's economy, to keep our economy strong. I want to keep investing in jobs, in the skills we need for the future, in trades training centres and apprenticeships. I want to train more doctors and more nurses. I want to build the national broadband network so we are prosperous for the future. And I don't want to see Australians take a risk of the reintroduction of work choices and Mr Abbott's planned cuts to health and education.
Prime Minister, with the sales pitch out of the way, do you think that there are more undecided voters out there at the moment compared to former campaigns?
Well, when we look at the polls this morning, there is a real risk that Australians will wake up on Sunday and Mr Abbott will be Prime Minister. And that does mean there's a real risk work choices will be back. And of course, Mr Abbott has pledged cuts to health and cuts to education in this campaign, $1 billion out of apprenticeships, $1 billion out of the pharmaceutical benefits scheme. Instead, I'm asking Australians to endorse my positive plan for jobs, for better schools, for decent healthcare, and to build the national broadband network. I don't want to see this nation fall behind the standards of the world when it comes to infrastructure that's like exporting jobs overseas.
Prime Minister, you had to face four negative questions during the week from the Broncos Club about Kevin Rudd. Have you done everything you can to make sure that a Gillard government will be installed and will be given the endorsement of the majority?
Well, I am campaigning and continuing to campaign hard. I don't want to see this nation go back to work choices, and that's a real risk under Mr Abbott. I do want to see my positive plans for the future of the economy and my investments in education and healthcare go ahead. I think Australians deserve to have great schools for their kids and decent hospitals. That's what the choice comes down to tomorrow. whether we invest in services or cut services, whether we have fair work or work choices, whether we build the national broadband network or never see it built.
And Prime Minister, just finally, is there a good luck charm that you'll be carrying with you to the election tomorrow?
I'm not a very superstitious person, but I am a determined person. You will see me continuing to talk to people out here in Western Sydney about my positive plan for the future.
Prime Minister Julia Gillard, thank you very much for your time. Tony Abbott is about to join us. Before we do let you go, is there one thing you'd like to say to him? I believe he can hear you right now.
Tony Abbott would agree with me that this is a tough, close contest. And I'd say to Tony Abbott and I'd say to the Australian people that it is a contest between my positive plan versus the risk of services cuts and a return to work choices.
Prime Minister Julia Gillard, thanks for joining us. Tony Abbott, while the Prime Minister is still there, your message to her?
Well, I just say to the Australian people that if you want to end the waste, to pay back the debt, stop the big new taxes and stop the boats, you've got to change the government. The only way to change the government is to get rid of your local Labor member. The Prime Minister says that this election is a risk. Well, the big risk is that a really bad government might get the second chance that it doesn't deserve and that Australia can't afford.
Well, that's the sales pitch, I think, out of the way. Mr. Abbott, can you work, if it is a hung parliament, can you possibly form a working government with the Greens?
Well, the one thing you won't see from me is any support for a carbon tax or an emissions trading scheme. There is a secret preference deal between Labor and the Greens, and as sure as night follows day, if there is a Gillard government elected, there will be a carbon tax, and that basically means an enormous slug on your power bills.
Tony Abbott, we all know you can hold your own in terms of endurance events on the sporting field, but how has this campaign tested you, and will you finish tonight confident that you've done everything you possibly can?
Look, I'm seeking the biggest job in the country, and if you want a big job, you've got to make a big effort. And I'll finish this campaign tired but confident that I've done everything that I can and that my team has done everything that it can to put a positive message about our good policies and expose the kind of lies and hypocrisy and broken promises and wasted money that has been the record of this government.
Now, we understand you're bringing all the family together now on the eve of the election, and you will be able to spend some time with them after this lengthy run, the 36 hours you've talked about. Is there something in your kit bag, as Deborah mentioned to the Prime Minister, a lucky charm or something you're looking forward to as an omen of victory perhaps tomorrow?
Look, I think probably the thing that's given me the greatest satisfaction is having my wife and my kids on the campaign trail. This is probably the first time that they've taken a really passionate interest in politics, but they know how important this election is. It's very important that we should save Australia from a really bad, incompetent government that doesn't deserve to be re-elected.
Tony Abbott, thank you for your time tonight.
Thanks so much. Thanks, Bill. Thanks, Deb.